Hi, it's Corrine, and today I'd like to share a tutorial with you. I'm going to show you how to make a chipboard box from start to finish and hopefully teach the concept of making a box. Once you understand the concept of how to make a chipboard box, you can then change it to any size that you need, make it into any size that you need. So stay tuned. I'll go over all the supplies that I needed to make this box. And if you have any questions, leave me a comment. I hope you enjoy. Okay, so to get started, I thought I would show you a few of the supplies that I pulled out. The first thing you're going to need is chipboard. I'm using Graphics medium weight chipboard, and I'll put a link in the description box. I get this from either walmart.com or Amazon, whoever has the best price at the time. The other thing you will need is cardstock. I like to use, and this is for my mini albums as well, a 65-pound weight smooth cardstock. If you're getting cracking with your mini albums, or in this case a chipboard box, the chances are it's going to be because of the type of paper that you're using. So you don't want to use too thick of a cardstock, but you need it heavy enough for it to be sturdy. So I like to use a 65-pound weight. And you want to use the color cardstock of what you want your end box to be, along with most likely pattern paper. So in this case, I'm going to wrap my box in black, but I thought I would show this as an example of one of the papers that I use. Again, you can find this at walmart.com or Amazon for the Nina. And then today I'm going to be using this Astro Brights cardstock, again, 65-pound weight. The next thing you're going to need is a wet adhesive. I like using Fabri-Tac Beacon. You're going to need a strong double-sided tape. I'm using Miracle Tape from Viva Las Vegas. You're going to need a ruler. I'm using a Tim Holtz centering ruler, a bone folder. A craft knife is optional, but I like to use that because you also need scissors, so that's why the craft knife is optional. I like to use a pencil, and I use my Tim Holtz paper piercer to remove the backing on the tape. A few other things that are optional. I'll be using a Sharpie marker, but again, this is optional. I'll explain more of that later. You can also use some distress paint. I like using this because of the dauber top. It makes it easy. If you don't have a Sharpie marker, the Sharpie marker is going to be the easiest thing to use. And again, we'll go over why a little bit later. Something else that's optional is this Perfect Trim Ruler. You can get it from perfecttrimruler.com. It will help us miter our corners. And another thing that I'm using is a template for the spacing of my box. It's simply two pieces of the medium weight chipboard that I'm using adhered together. You can eyeball this, but you're going to need a good little space, about a 1/8 inch in between the sides of your box, so when you fold it up, it's not pushing into each other, which will cause cracking. So you're going to need a little bit spacing. I like to use the template. It just makes things a little bit easier. So let me set this stuff aside. The first thing I'd like to go over is the measurements of my album. The very first thing you want to start with, and before I start, let me just say that if you're making a black box, if you can use black chipboard, it's going to make it easier. If you're making a white box and you want to use white chipboard, it's going to hide any of the natural chipboard showing through, which we'll get more into that in a little bit. The reason I have a black piece of chipboard, I like using just the natural craft chipboard. I buy it in bulk. Therefore I have a lot of it, but I'm waiting on my order to come in, so I didn't have a large enough size that I needed, so I pulled out the black chipboard. It's the exact same, it's just black, but I wanted to use the natural. I thought it would be a little bit easier to see on camera, but like I said, I didn't have a large enough size, so that's why I'm using black as well. So the very first thing I do is determine the size of the box that I need. Today I'm making a rectangle for my box. And I'm using this mini album as my guide. I wanted a visual to show you how I determine the size. So my mini album is 7¾ by 6. So I decided to make the bottom of the box 1/2 inch longer and wider. Therefore, I came to the determination that I want my box to be 8¼ by 6½. The very next thing I do is cut my box lid. You always want your lid to be a slightly larger, so when it sits on top of your box, it sits nicely. You can make it 1/4 inch larger if you want. I like to make mine 3/8 of an inch larger. That way, when I'm using pattern paper and you're putting the lid on, it's not so tight that it's gonna crumple your paper as you put it on. Again, if you want a more snug fit, you wanna do 1/4 of an inch. But I like to make mine 3/8 of an inch larger. Therefore, my box lid is going to be 8 5/8 by 6 7/8. Okay, the next thing we're going to need, and I'm gonna use the bottom of my box here as an example, we're going to need the sides of our box. Whatever height you want your box to be is completely up to you. However, the length and width need to match the bottom of your box. So I determined I wanted my height to be 5 inches. I could have made it 2 inches, I could have made it 10 inches. It does not matter. But what does matter is it has to match the length and width of the bottom of your box. Therefore, all my pieces for my sides are going to be 5 inches because that's the height of my box. However, I need 2 pieces to go on the long sides. Therefore, my 2 pieces are 5 inches tall, of course, by 8 1/4. It's going to match the length of my box, the 8 1/4. The width of my box, as you can see here, is 6 1/2. So I needed 2 pieces, 6 1/2 by 5 inches tall. Therefore, it's going to sit like this when we're done. See if I can do this with one hand, or two hands, I guess. Okay, so that's gonna be our box when we're done. So the height of the box has to match all the way around, and the width and the sides have to match the bottom of your box. Now, the next thing we need is the sides of our box. How long you want the sides to go down on your box. I like it to be 1 inch. You can make it 1 1/2 inch, whatever you'd like. But again, we need them to match the exact length and width of your box. How tall or how long you want them to go down the side is completely up to you. Mine being 1 inch, I cut them all to 1 inch, all 4 pieces. And then I have 2 pieces that are cut to 8 5/8, which is the exact same length of my lid by 1 inch. And then 2 pieces that are 6 7/8, which is the same as the width on my box. So we're gonna have one here, and then on that side. That's gonna be our lid. We'll go all through all of this as we go. So the next thing we're going to need is our cardstock. And we're going to wrap both the bottom of our box and the lid of our box. So you want to make the cardstock 1 inch larger than whatever size your bottom of your box is and the lid of your box. So the bottom of my box is 8 1/4 by 6 1/2. Therefore, I made it 1 inch larger on the length and the width. So it's 9 1/4 by 7 1/2. Okay, it's gonna sit like that and we're gonna wrap it. Same with the paper that's gonna wrap around the box lid, 1 inch larger. Our lid is 8 5/8 because remember we made it 3/8 inch larger than the bottom. So it's 8 5/8 by 6 7/8. Therefore, our cardstock, being 1 inch larger, is 9 5/8 by 7 7/8. Okay, and we're going to wrap those. Then we need 4 pieces. You may need more or you may need less. I'll explain more as we're wrapping. It'll make more sense. But for the box I'm making, I needed 4 pieces of cardstock for my side pieces. Okay. My side pieces are 5 inches tall or 5 inches wide. You want to make your cardstock 2 inches larger. I'm using 8 1/2 by 11 paper, and I'm not going to cut down the 11 inch. We most likely will have to cut that down at the very end, but we're going to wait till the end to do that. As we're going through this, this will all make more sense. But regardless, you want to make your cardstock 2 inches taller than your chipboard. So ours is 5 inches tall. Therefore, our 4 pieces are 7 by 11. We are also going to need the paper to wrap around our sides for our lid. Our lid is going to be, the sides on our lid is 1 inches. We want to make these 1 1/2 inch taller. not worrying about the 11 inches at this point. We're going to leave it at 11 inches, but the height of it, we want it to be 1 1/2 inch larger. It'll all make sense as we're working on this. So let me set all this aside. And the first thing we're going to do is wrap the lid and the bottom of our box. So let me set this stuff aside. Here's the bottom of our box. There's so many ways you can do this. You can use double-sided tape, wet adhesive, whatever is most comfortable for you. I like using double-sided tape because I know it's not going to come apart. And then I also will combine it with wet adhesive. So let me just quickly add this on. Use my bone folder to make sure it is burnished down well. Here's where I like to use my paper piercer. It just makes it super quick. And go ahead and center that in your piece. It does not have to be perfect. You can eyeball this. Let me go ahead and add a little bit of wet adhesive. Actually, to make this a little bit quicker, I'm going to use my ATG. Okay, and let me go ahead and completely wrap this one. We'll do the lid here in a second. So go ahead and use your perfect trim ruler if you have one. This is not necessary. You don't have to have this. You can eyeball it, but no matter what, we're going to miter the corners, which means we're going to cut the corners off because we don't want extra bulk here when we go to fold it. But you do not want to cut all the way up to your chipboard. It will leave exposed chipboard. So you want to leave about a 1/8 inch gap after your chipboard before you cut it off. So this I'm going to use quickly to give me a guide to follow. And now I'm going to quickly add my double-sided tape all the way around this. You're also going to need more cardstock for your mat pieces on the inside, or you can use pattern paper. Today I've already pre-cut all my mat pieces just out in the black cardstock just to make it quick and easy, but you can use cardstock for that. You can use pattern paper for that rather when it comes to that, but we'll go over that in a moment. So now the next thing I need to do is follow my pencil lines and cut off my corners. And let me give you a close-up. I did not cut all the way to that chipboard. I left about a 1/8 inch. We're going to do our lid the exact same way. Now go ahead and fold on that cardstock just to kind of get the cardstock moving in the direction that you need it to move. And then I like to just kind of fold it with my hands as well. Okay, so I'm going to remove all my tape backing. And go ahead and fold down two of your long sides first because we're going to tuck in the corners again to alleviate a bulky or pointy corner. So go ahead and fold over one of your long sides. And here's where I like to use my bone folder to go over it to give it a good crease, make sure it's adhered down well. Now go ahead and do the opposite side. Do the exact same thing, just fold that over. Okay, and now you want to go ahead and tuck in your corners, therefore you don't get a pointy corner. Here is a pointy corner. Hopefully you can see that. Okay, and here's the other side where I've tucked it in. It's just going to help when you fold it that it doesn't have a real sharp point to it. So do that to all corners. and then go ahead and fold those down, giving them a nice crease, a nice press with your bone folder. Okay, and now you can go over all the sides with your bone folder, make sure it's creased down well. And then we're going to be adding a matte piece to the center of this. I'll go over that in just a moment. Let's do the exact same thing to the lid of our box. And I'm going to put this in fast play to make it a little bit quicker. Okay, so now we have both the bottom of our box and our box lid covered and wrapped with paper. I'm not worried about my writing because I plan on using some pattern paper on the top, which brings me to the inside. You can wait and use pattern paper for the inside. I'm just going to, for demonstration's sake, show you right now what I'm doing. I'm going to use black cardstock and use these and adhere them to the inside. Okay, so I made them 1/4 inch smaller as my mat piece, and I'm going to adhere that right now. You can wait on this step and do it later. I like to remove one side of my adhesive because then it kind of slides around. I can get it right where I want, press it down, and then go back, lift it up, and remove the rest of the backing, and then I know it's going to be centered exactly where I want it to be. Okay, so I'll press that down. Now I have it perfectly covered. Again, I'm not worried about my writing. I'll be covering that when I decide on what pattern paper I want to use for my album. This is the inside mat for the bottom of my box, which again is 1/4 inch smaller, so I made it 8 by 6 1/4. For the lid, I made it 1/4 inch smaller, 8 3/8 by 6 5/8. So again, I'm just gonna kinda, it slides around being that I have the tape backing on three of the sides. So I'm gonna get it right where I want, press it down, then go back and remove the tape backing. And when you go to mat your cardstock, you're going to want to do the same thing. Just make it 1/4 inch smaller than the lid and base of your box. Okay, so for now, I also like to just kind of run it over with my brayer to make sure it's really pressed down well. Okay, so for now, the lid of our box and the bottom of our box are done. We're going to go ahead and set these aside and work on the sides of the box. Here is where the Sharpie marker or distress paint come in handy. If you're using a black chipboard, you don't need to worry about this step. Or if you're using a white chipboard and white cardstock, you don't have to worry about this. The only time you do have to worry about this is if you're using craft colored cardstock and you're wrapping it in either white or black. So what I like to do, let me get a scrap piece of paper. Here is the sides of my box. I'm going to, on one of the sides, mark it with a Sharpie marker because a very tiny bit of that edge will show when our box is done. So we're just gonna hide that. It won't show a lot. It'll all make sense again closer we get to what we're doing here. But this is completely optional. I like to do it because I don't want any of my chipboard showing. Now, I would not be doing this if I was wrapping it in white paper. I wouldn't want this black to stand out. I would do this in white, either a white pen marker or white distress ink. You could even use acrylic paint if you wanted to. And you don't have to use anything at all. This may not bother you. You may not even see this, or it may not stand out to you. Okay, so that was quickly all I needed to do. I'm actually going to do my sides of my lid as well, just since I have the Sharpie marker out. Okay, so I'll set those aside. And again, we're going to be working on our sides of our box. We need to use our cardstock and overlap them on the long side. So here's my 11 inches. I'm going to use my half inch square tape and I'm going to overlap them. So I'm going to put the tape right at the edge. Let me set this under so maybe you can see a little bit better. And I'm going to just place that down following the edge of my paper. And again, this is cut to 7 by 11 inches. And I went over the edge here slightly, so I'm just going to roll that tape back. I don't want it sticking out too much. And now we're just going to overlap these by 1/2 inch. If you don't have 1/2 inch tape, you can use 2 pieces of 1/4 inch tape. And we have 4 of these pieces, so I'm going to do this 2 more times. We're connecting all 4 of our pieces together. It's going to give us 1 long continuous piece. Some of this is going to be off screen. It's a little bit awkward and long, but hopefully you understand what I'm doing here. Again, just overlapping all 4 pieces. If you're making a larger box, you may be overlapping 6 pieces, or if you're making a smaller box, you may only be overlapping 2 pieces. But I know ahead of time that I need 4 pieces to accommodate my box. So 4 pieces, 7 by 11 inches. Press that down and adhere my last piece here. Okay, so I know some of this is off camera, but we have 1 long continuous piece. Okay, and I'm going to start with this piece on the end here. And if you're making a rectangle box like I am, you're going to have 2 pieces that are shorter and 2 of the longer pieces. You're going to want to alternate them because you want, it's going to fold up like a box. You're going to need the 2 shorter pieces on either end and then the 2 longer pieces on the opposite end. So I'm going to start with my short piece and I'm going to give myself a guide. This is not something you have to do, but it's something I like to do because I like to start out pretty even so it ends up even. You want your chipboard even on this because if it slightly goes, you know, a little sideways like this, you're going to run out of paper down here to wrap it around. Okay, so if you remember, we cut our cardstock 2 inches larger than our 5-inch side. So we're going to have 1 extra inch on this side and 1 extra inch on this side. So I'm going to go up 1 inch on my ruler and mark that so I have a guide of where to adhere my chipboard down. Okay, so I have a 1-inch guide here to get me started with adhering this down. I'm going to leave approximately 1 inch. I'm not going to measure that, but I'm going to leave approximately 1 inch on the edge here as well. So for this, I'm going to adhere the smaller piece, the 5 by 6.5, add my wet adhesive. I want to make sure to go around all the edges. and just kind of follow my score or my pencil line there. Go ahead and press that down, make sure it's adhering well. And now this is where my template comes in, my little template that I made. You need to leave a 1/8 inch gap, which is also two thicknesses of the chipboard that you're using, because when your box folds, if it's right against each other, it's going to crack and interfere and will not fold correctly. If you leave a little bit of a gap, when it folds up nicely. You actually want it to fold against each other like this when you're done. So you need to leave a little gap. So now, being that I use the 5 by 6.5, I want to use my longer piece as my next piece. As you remember, we're alternating them. So I'm going to add my wet adhesive, again using my Beacon Fabri-Tac. Make sure to get around all the edges. You can use whatever adhesive you want for this. And I'm going to use my little guide to make sure it's spaced correctly. Okay, and I'll adhere that down. Now I'm going to go back to my smaller piece again and adhere that one down. Okay, and on to my last larger piece. Okay, so now we have all this excess. So here's where my craft knife comes in handy. I'm just gonna cut that off real quick. Okay, so we don't need this piece. And now we're going to miter the corners just as we did when we wrapped our chipboard. So go ahead and use your pencil mark. Okay, so go ahead and cut off those corners. I'm going to do all four corners, not cutting up to that chipboard, leaving a tiny bit of a gap. Okay, and now we need to cut in between each piece of where the chipboard meets, and that's going to alleviate a lot of bulk when we go to fold it. So I'm going to take out a little triangle piece here where on both sides where the chipboard meets. And you want to do the same thing. You want to cut up to that chipboard, but not beyond the chipboard. So we're taking out just a small triangular piece. Let me use my other scissors here. We're going to do that all where all the chipboard meets. I'll give you a close-up look here in just a moment. let me show you up close what we're doing. And I'm cutting right up to the edge of that chipboard. So hopefully you can see that. I'm going to do that on the other side as well. Okay, so now we've removed all of the pieces where those meet. We want to go ahead and fold up on those, just kind of showing the paper which way we want it to go. Sorry that I can't get the entire thing in frame, but hopefully you can see what I'm doing here. And next thing we're going to do is fold in one of our sides, not both sides, just one. We're going to glue that down. I'm going to go ahead and use my wet glue for this. And put adhesive along this entire edge. And adhere that right down to the chipboard. Fold that over, press it down. I have a little bit of glue seeping out. Just kind of wipe it off. Okay, so once I'm pretty happy with that and I know it's adhered down, you can use a glue eraser or remover to kind of get off that excess. That comes off great with this Fabri-Tac. Next thing we're going to do is adhere down all of the one side. You do not want to do this side. Just choose one side and adhere it down onto the chipboard. Again, do not adhere both sides. So I'm going to adhere it the exact same way. And I also want to tuck in this corner here just as we did so I don't have a sharp corner. And go ahead and add your adhesive to this entire flap. You can use ATG, whatever you'd like to use. And adhere this down. And we're going to do that along the entire one side. Okay, so now we've covered entire one side. We're going to leave this side open. Okay, and now because we left this gap in between all the pieces of chipboard, it's going to fold up nicely without interfering with each side of the chipboard. Okay, so the next thing I like to do is add the mat piece to this inside. You can use pattern paper for this. I am going to use black cardstock because I haven't even decided yet what pattern paper I want to use. So you're going to need four pieces, one to cover each piece of your raw chipboard. And the chipboard is 5 by 6.5. We have two pieces of that. And then we have 5 by 8.25. So I cut all my pieces to 5 inches tall. Then on the 6.5 piece, I cut it slightly smaller because if you go too far to the edge, when you fold your paper, it's going to buckle and crinkle there and it's going to look terrible. So if you want to know the exact size I cut it to 5 by 6 7/16. Again, 5 by 6.5, and I just took a slight bit off the 6.5 length For the longer side, which are 5 inches tall, I cut it the same height, 5 inches tall, and it's by 8 1/4, slightly smaller. So I cut it to 8 3/16. So just slightly smaller than 8 1/4. And then I did all 4 pieces. So let me go ahead and adhere those down. You want to make sure your adhesive is around the entire edge. I think for this, I'll use wet adhesive. Okay, when adhering this down, where your flap is open, you want to adhere it all the way to the top of that. We're trying to cover up this raw chipboard. On this side, we have a black border, so we don't have to worry about it. So you want to, even though it's pretty much the same height, you want to just make sure that it's butted up all the way against the edge where the flap is open. And being that we didn't cut it to the exact size of the chipboard, like I said, I made it, this one's 6 1/2, I made it slightly smaller. That's the purpose of coloring these black, because if you put it too far, like I had mentioned, and you are folding your box, it's going to crinkle up here in the corners. So by making it slightly smaller, you avoid that mess of it being crinkled. And then by coloring it black, you avoid seeing the raw chipboard underneath. Now, if you're using black chipboard, you don't have to worry about that. So again, I'm going to make sure this is all the way up against the edge here. I like to use my brayer to make sure it's adhered down well. So now you may not pick up on this on camera, but I can see it in real life. Very slightly, my chipboard is showing right here. So had I not colored it black, you would have seen the craft colored chipboard in between. Now when the box is folded, it hides it slightly, but still I didn't want to take any chance of seeing that. So now I'm going to adhere my longer piece down. The next thing we want to do is this flap that we have not adhered down yet, we're going to adhere it to this side. Okay, so let me just kind of fold it up, make sure it's going to be easy for me to adhere down. And I'm going to simply make my box and fold it. And this is what's going to make the bottom of our box, or the main portion of our box. So I'm going to, you can glue it on the inside or the outside, whatever you choose to do. I'm going to do it on the outside so it's a continuous fold here, because I will be adding pattern paper to it in the end. So again, using my wet adhesive. Make sure you're matching it up so it matches up nicely. And I'm just going to fold it up on itself, or on the other side, actually. Okay, so here are the sides of our box. The next thing we need to do is go ahead and adhere the inside of our box. Grab the inside of your box piece, which is the bottom of your box. It's going to be the smaller of the two pieces. And go ahead and just kind of press it down in there. And now we're going to adhere the sides down. So it fits nicely in there. I'm just going to kind of fold this back, add some wet adhesive. Get this out of the way here. Okay, I'm pretty liberal with the wet adhesive, and just kind of fold that over. We will also press it from the inside as well, but I want to get it to start adhering slightly. Okay, now go ahead and fold that over and press down firmly right on the side that you have the glue. Okay, Okay, and once you're happy with that, go ahead and do the other side and then the last two sides as well. Flip that over and really press it down from the inside. And now I'll do the last two sides. Okay, and I'm really happy with how this turned out. So there is the bottom and sides of our box. We need to go ahead and make the lid for our box. So let me get the sides here. We're going to be working with the 1-inch sides. Again, the four pieces that we have two pieces that are 8 5/8 by 1 inch, and then two pieces that are 6 7/8 by 1 inch. Those match the size of our lid perfectly. And we're going to do the exact same thing. We're going to overlap these four pieces. So I'm going to use my double-sided tape and adhere these four pieces together. Okay, so we're going to do the exact same thing as we did for the sides of our box. We're going to alternate our pieces from the smaller piece to the larger piece. I gave myself on this one a 1/2 inch guideline. This is 1 1/2 inch larger than our 1-inch piece, and that's because I wanted to leave myself a flap that we're going to adhere onto the lid, which you'll see in a moment. So I'm going to start with my smaller piece. I'm going to leave a little, I'm not going to butt it up to the edge there. I'm just going to use my wet adhesive and adhere it down. And you want to leave the exact same gap that you did with the sides of your box. So I'll use my template for that as well. So again, I'm going to leave a little space here. I'm not going to glue all the way to the edge and just follow my pencil line. It is not even because I want this part to be a little bit larger. That's what we're adhering to the lid of our box. So press that down. Now I'm going to add my adhesive to my longer piece. This is my 8 5/8 by 1 inch. That first piece I put on was 6 7/8 by 1 inch. And I'm using the same template I did. Okay, so go ahead and cut off the excess that you don't need. I'm just going to eyeball this. Leave yourself a tab though, because you're going to need to adhere that. And now we need to miter the corners on this as well. Okay, so go ahead and cut off those corners there. Okay, and as you can see, I did both corners. Now we're going to cut in between the chipboard just like we did on the sides of the box. So let me fast forward through that. Okay, so just like we did on the first one, go ahead and adhere one of the side flaps down. Do not do both. And now go ahead and fold up on all of your sides just to kind of get your paper moving in the direction that we need it to go. And now we have one longer flap and the shorter flap. We want to adhere down the shorter flap to the one side. Do not adhere the other side yet. Okay, so I have all of one side adhered down, and now I'm going to add my inside mat pieces. Again, you can use pattern paper if you want. I'm just using black. These are 6 7/8 by 1 is my shorter piece. So I did two pieces that are 6 7/8 slightly smaller, just as I did for the sides of the box. So I'm just going to quickly adhere those down again, butting them all the way up against the edge with the flap, and then there will be slight sides. They will not go all the way to the end of the sides, but that's why we did the black Sharpie marker, and it will cover that, but yet it won't bulk up when we fold it. Okay, so I've added my mat pieces to the entire inside, and now we want to adhere this leftover flap, just as we did the sides, we want to adhere that to the outside of this box. So I'm going to add my wet adhesive. Fold this over and adhere it. Try and line it up as best as you can. Okay, so we're going to add the lid to our box the exact same way. Just kind of set it inside, flip it over, and we're going to go ahead and adhere the sides down. Thank you. Okay, so here is the lid of our box. I'm really happy with how this turned out. Again, I would add pattern paper to this and finish this off, make it nice. And my favorite part is when I put the lid on. So now this lid has a tiny bit. I'm going to push it up against one side so you can see, hopefully. The lid has a little bit of a gap in it, which is what I like. And the reason I like that is because I usually will add pattern paper to all around the sides. So when you have your lid put on, you don't want it so snug that it pushes against that pattern paper and possibly tears it. So I prefer a little bit of a larger lid, which in the beginning, like I explained, I make my lids 3/8 of an inch larger. If you don't want that little bit of a gap and you want it pretty snug, you only want to give your lid a 1/4 inch gap. So I hope you've learned something. I hope this is helpful to you. If you have any questions, please let me know. And here is my album. Let's see how it fits in here. Perfect. I'm very happy with that. So thanks so much for watching.